Welcome everyone. Thank you for tuning in. I'm watching this broadcast. I'm Sir Jackson. Stay blessed as we share the word of God. As I flip my Bible over to the book of Kings from chapter 11, I read from verse 29. And it came to pass at that time, when Jeroboam went out to Jerusalem, that the prophet Ahijah the Shilonite found him in the way. And he had clad himself with a new garment, and they two were alone in the field. And Ahijah cut the new garment that was on him, and rent it in 12 pieces, and said to Jeroboam, take thee 10 pieces, for thus saith the Lord, the God of Israel, behold, I will rend the kingdom out of the hand of Solomon, and will give 10 tribes to thee, but he shall have one tribe for my servant David's sake, and for Jerusalem's sake, the city which I have chosen out of all the tribes of Israel. Here comes the prophet Ahijah of Shilonite to a man called Jeroboam. Jeroboam was a man of valor, an industrious man under King Solomon's. The word of the Lord came unto Jeroboam, said, the Lord has given you 10 tribes of Israel. The word from the prophet Ahijah. Stay tuned with me. Let's flip over to verse 12, verse 43. And Solomon slept with his fathers and was buried in the city of David his father, and Rehoboam his son reigned in his stead. So Rehoboam reigned in the stead of Solomon. But in chapter 12, and Rehoboam went to Shechem, for all Israel were come to Shechem to make him king. And it came to pass, when Jeroboam the son of Nebat, who was yet in Egypt, heard of it, for he was fled from the presence of King Solomon, and Jeroboam dwelt in Egypt, that they sent and called him. And Jeroboam and all the congregation of Israel came and spake unto Rehoboam, saying, thy father made thy yoke grievous. Now therefore, make thou the grievous service of thy fathers, and his heavy yoke which he put upon us lighter, and we will serve thee. And he said unto them, depart yet for 3 days, then come again to me. And the people departed. And the king Rehoboam consulted the old men that stood before Solomon his father, while he yet lived, and said, how do ye advise that I may answer these people? And they spake unto him, saying, if thou wilt be a servant unto these people this day, and will serve them, and answer them, and speak good words to them, then they will be thy servants forever. But if forsook the counsel of the old men, he should have took this counsel of the old men. But because of the word which Ahijah the Shilonite spoken, the word concerning Jeroboam had to come to pass. Look what he did. But if forsook, he refused the counsel of the old men who have worked with his father Solomon. He forsook the counsel of the old men which they had given him, and consulted with the young men that were grown up with him. He went to the young men of whom were his contemporaries, whom he grew up with, and which stood before him. And he said unto them, what counsel give ye that we may answer these people who have spoken to me, saying, make the yoke which thy fathers did upon us lighter? He seek counsel from the young contemporary, because he had told the people to go for 3 days and came back for answer. And the young men that were grown up with him spake unto him, saying, thus shalt thou speak unto these people that spake unto thee, saying, thy fathers made our yoke heavy, but make thou it lighter upon us. Thou shalt thou say unto them, my little finger shall be thicker than my father's loins. You see the wrong advice which this young contemporary gave to Rehoboam. He forsook the counsel of the old men who gave him the right advice. He chose to take the wrong advice of the young men who are his contemporaries. And now, whereas my father did lay you with heavy yoke, I will add to your yoke. My fathers have chastised you with whips, but I will chastise you with scorpions. So Rehoboam went to these young men, and the young men gave Rehoboam young advice. All this is just for the word of God to come to pass in the life of Jeroboam. So Jeroboam and all the people came to Rehoboam the third day, as the king had appointed, saying, come to me again the third day. And the king answered the people roughly and forsook the old men's counsel that they gave him, and spake to them after the counsel of the young men, saying, my fathers made you your yoke heavy, and I will add to your yoke. My fathers also chastised you with whips, but I will chastise you with scorpions. So Rehoboam forsook the counsel of the old men and chose to take the counsel of his young friends, his contemporaries, which was the wrong advice. Wherefore the king hearkened not unto the people, for the cause was from the Lord. All this is for the word of the Lord of the prophet Ahijah the Shilonite upon the life of Jeroboam to come to pass, that he might perform his saying which the Lord spake by Ahijah the Shilonite unto Jeroboam the son of Nebat. So when all Israel saw that the king had a not unto them, the people answered the king, saying, what portion have we in David? Neither have we inheritance in the son of Jesse. To your tent, O Israel, now see to thine own house, David. So Israel departed unto their tent. From that day, the house of Israel split. They only left the house of Judah, which belongs to David, unto Rehoboam. But as for the children of Israel, which dwelt in the cities of Judah, Rehoboam reigned over them. So Rehoboam lose the entire 10 tribes of Israel because he chose to take the counsel of his young men and refuse the counsel of the old men who have walked with his father. But all this was for the word which was spoken by the prophet Ahijah the Shilonite to the life of upon the life of Jeroboam to come to pass. So if Israel rebelled against the house of David unto this day, because Rehoboam refused the counsel of the old men who have worked with his father, he lose the 10 tribes of Israel. But all this was for the word of the Lord to be accomplished in the life of Jeroboam. So I admonish you this day, even as you listen to this word, to continue to take counsel of the Lord, walk with God, turn from every wicked way, live for God, serve the Lord with all your heart, trust in Him. He said, behold, I am the Lord, the God of all strength and might. Serve the Lord, trust in the Lord, and lean not on your own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Serve the Lord with all your heart. Worship the Lord with all your heart, and he shall direct your path and make your path straight. Let's pray. Merciful Father, thank you, Lord, even as we share the word of God, this Bible study, as we study the word together with my people, even as we share. Bless the heart of my people as they go about, and make your word be hidden in their hearts so that they will serve you forevermore. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen. Thank you. I'm Sil Jackson. I hope you've been blessed with this as we share the word together and read this Bible study. I hope you've been blessed with the story of Jeroboam and Rehoboam and King Solomon. Stay blessed. Tune in for the next broadcast. I'm Sue Jackson. Peace. Jackson, the priest.